Hello everyone! In this video we will talk about different attempts to approximate pi using series. And the first such description was given in Sanskrit by Indian astronomer Nilakantha Samayaji in around 1500 AD. His series you can see here at this picture, and our task here to find the sum of 20 summons of this series. Moreover, we want to see the sequence of the series. That is, we want to construct a sequence where each term of the sequence we add one more summon of the series up to 20. So the first term will be, for example, just 3. The second term we add the second summon, we get the sum of these two. The third term of the sequence will be these 3 summons, and so on. And the first thing that we are going to do is to write down this sum as a unique sum using this sigma sign. Of course, for this we need to see the pattern of this series. The first summon here is clear, this is just 3, so you can see it here, plus, and you see that each next summon contains 4 in numerator, so we can take this 4 out of the sum. Next, you can notice that the sign here alternate. So there is first plus and minus, then plus and minus, and so on. So this one is clear from this numerator here. This is minus 1 to the power. So if j equals 1, then we have power 2. So this is positive sign. If j equals 2, the power is 3, we get negative sign, so this is second summon here, and so on. And what we have in the denominator, we have the product of 3 numbers each time. And the product, in fact, of 3 subsequent numbers, so here 2, 3, 4, 4, 5, 6, 6, 7, 8, and so on. Next one will be 8, 9, 10, right? And so on. So, and we can notice that the first factor in this product is even number. So this is 2, 4, 6, and so on. So therefore we write here 2j. This is even number. For j equals 1, this is 2. For j equals 2, this is 4, and so on. And next factor is just next number after 2j, which is 2j plus 1. And after this number, we get 2j plus 2. So denominator is this product. After that, we can now easily to insert this term into Excel to see, to calculate the value. Okay, let's try to do this. And the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to create a column of indices. So we need from 1 up to 20, right? So therefore, I'm going to construct the column of indices from 1 up to 20. Let me do this. Okay, maybe somewhere here. So we start from 1. 2. And in Excel we have so-called autofill. If we take these 2 cells and if we move our mouse to this angle, the right bottom angle of this box, we can see some little black cross. If we take this cross and pull this down, we can autofill up to, you can see the numbers appeared up to 20. So here we can see the indices of this sum. Next one, I'm going to calculate each summand, this value under the sum. In Excel, to type formulas, we use equality sign. And next we can type the formula, and instead of j, we will use the index which we have in this column E. So we can type minus 1 to the power, and in the power we have j plus 1. So j is this column plus 1, and everything over. And here we have 2 times the index times 2 times the index plus 1 times 2 times the index plus 2 and close this bracket. So this is denominator, and press enter to see the result. And again, we can use autofill to repeat all these things, and each time Excel will use the index as the number in the cell on the left automatically. So here we use E1, here you see Excel uses E2, E3, and so on. This is quite convenient, and so we calculated up to 20 such numbers. Now we need just make it in one sum. So for the first, let me just write some here. So for the first sum, we get just 3, right? And for the next one, we get 3 plus 4 times, and we need just the first sum, so this one here, right? Okay. And for the next one, we need this one plus 4 times this one, right? So what we already got, so this 2 summons plus 4 times next summoned. Okay, and we can autofill this again. So here we have, for example, G3, so this cell, plus 4 times F3, so this cell, and so on until 20 is summoned. So this is a sequence of this given series.